Chapter 48, the header. Why Jesus began to speak in parables to the people. The way to understand the parables and symbolism of the scripture is given. The final latter-day prophet will be given the ability to understand and explain all parables that have been given, but will only do so according to the commandment of the Spirit. The rich are condemned. 1. And now, I have been given a commandment of the Lord. Yea, this is the commandment that I have rejoiced in all the days of my life, even the one that I have waited for all my life to expound upon and speak about with all the energies of my soul. 2. Behold, I have been given the commandment to explain in plainness the mission and purpose of the life of Jesus Christ and the reason why it was necessary that he come into the world and live his life as he did, and teach the things that he taught unto all of us, according to our cultures and our abilities to understand him. 3. And throughout the scriptures that ye have among you in the latter days, and also throughout this sealed portion of the record of my Father, many of the holy prophets have taught you many of the things that I am about to expound unto you. 4. And many times they were commanded that they should speak unto you in parables and allegories, even in great similitude and symbolism of that which I have now been given permission by the Lord to give unto you in plainness. 5. Even the Lord himself began to speak unto the people in parables, after he had given unto them his gospel in plainness, concerning the things that I am about to explain unto you. And the Lord would have continued to speak unto the people in plainness, had they not rejected the simplicity of his words and his message. 6. And his disciples came and said unto him, Why speakest thou unto them in parables? And he answered and said unto his disciples, Because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. 7. For whosoever receiveth, to him shall be given, and he shall have more abundance, but whosoever continueth not to receive, from him shall be taken away even that he hath. 8. Therefore speak I to them in parables, because they seeing see not, and hearing they hear not, neither do they understand, and in them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah, which saith, Go and tell this people, Hear ye indeed, but understand not, and see ye indeed, but perceive not. Make the heart of this people fat, and make their ears heavy, and shut their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and convert, and be healed. 9. Yea, by hearing they shall hear, and shall not understand, and seeing they shall see, and shall not perceive. For the hearts of the people are waxed gross, and their ears are dull of hearing, and their eyes they have closed, lest at any time they should see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and should understand with their heart, and should be converted, and I should heal them. 10. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. For verily I say unto you, that many prophets and righteous men have desired to see those things which ye see, and have not seen them, and to hear those things which ye hear, and have not heard them. 11. And now, this Jesus said unto them regarding the prophets who had been given the gospel of Christ by the ministrations of the Spirit, but not by the literal voice of Christ in the flesh. 12. And now, I, Moroni, say unto all of you of the latter days who shall receive these things, even all the children of men of every tongue and every religion and every culture and every nation upon the face of the earth, yea, all of you have shut your eyes and have closed your ears and have hardened your hearts that ye do not understand the simplicity of the message of Christ that hath been given unto you. 13. And ye have been taught by parables and symbolism, and the similitude of the plainness that ye could have received from the Spirit of Christ, if ye were doing the works of Christ. And every parable, every teaching, every doctrine, every statement, every principle, every word that Christ spoke in the flesh taught the simple truths of his gospel. 14. But because of its simplicity, ye refuse to accept it, and open your eyes that ye might see, and your ears that ye might hear, and your hearts that ye might understand. 15. And now I have been commanded to give unto you in plainness the message and understanding of all the parables, the teachings, the doctrine, the statements, the principles, and all the words of Christ. And all these things that Christ did, he did to teach us the will of the Father, yea, even the will of the very eternal Father who created all of our spirits and set in motion the nature of the world on which we reside. 16. And the message of the Father is this: Behold, my beloved children, I have given unto you all these things that ye might find joy therein. And I am no respecter of persons, and would that ye should know that I esteem all flesh as one. 17. Yea, there is not one of my children that I do not esteem and love as much as the others. And to show this example of my love unto you, I have given unto you mine only begotten Son according to the flesh, and have bestowed upon him all of my powers and my authority, and have commanded him to do unto you as I would do unto you. 18. And I do not esteem him above any of you, but have given him unto you as your servant to teach you all the things that ye need to understand, so that it might be possible that ye might have this joy of which I have spoken. 19. Behold, I have created you that ye might have joy, and for no other purpose have I created you. For behold, I did not create you that ye might serve me, but that I might serve you by giving unto you this joy. 20. And the commandments that I have given unto my beloved Son are those commandments that I have given unto him to give to you. And only by these commandments can ye be assured of the joy of which I have spoken. 21. And I do not force any of you to obey these commandments, but have given unto each of you the ability to choose for yourselves how ye should live and how ye should act. 22. Nevertheless, I know that ye cannot find joy and live in eternal happiness unless ye obey the commandments that he hath given unto you. 23. Behold, my commandments are that ye love one another and do unto each other as ye would have another do unto you. And if ye follow this simple commandment, ye shall be happy. 24. And I have commanded you to give according to each of your abilities, and take according to each of your needs, esteeming one another as equal in all things. 25. And I have not commanded you to give glory unto any man. Yea, I have commanded against such things, even that you put one man above another among you. For ye are all my children, and regardless of what each of you do in the flesh, I will love and esteem you all the same. 26. And I do not love mine only begotten Son any more or less than I love any of you, but have given him unto you that he might teach unto you these things. And he loveth you as I love you, and hath commanded you to love one another as I have loved you. 27. And he seeketh not for your glory, or that ye should worship him, for he is your brother, and seeketh not the glory, but only the joy that he might receive from giving unto you the things which he hath received from me. 28. Behold, I am your Father, and have created you that ye might have joy, not that ye should honour me. For what manner of father would I be if I created you only that ye should honour me and give me glory? 29. Again, I say unto you, I did not create you to worship me, but to find joy in me. And for this reason, I have given unto you my commandments, even that ye should love one another and do unto others as ye would have them do unto you. 30. And now, my beloved children, I plead with you to act upon my promise, even that ye shall find joy if ye keep the commandments that I have given unto you through mine only begotten and beloved Son, Jesus Christ. 31. Yea, keep his commandments, and ye shall find joy. And if ye find joy, then ye are worshipping me. And in my kingdom ye shall find this joy and eternal happiness for ever. Amen. 32. And now I, Moroni, do testify unto you that this is the message that the Father hath given since the beginning of time. And it shall be the message that he shall give unto the end of time. And there is no other message that he shall give unto his children. 33. And it is this message that he spoke in the light, immediately after the darkness had lifted from up off the earth, at the time my fathers were gathered in the land of Bountiful. 34. And because they did not have the ability to receive his words through the Spirit at this time, they could not understand the Father. And for this reason, the Father introduced his Son, Jesus Christ, unto them, that they might hear his Son in the flesh. 35. And now, in the time of Jesus, when he began to teach these things unto the Jews, they could not accept the simplicity of this message. For they believed that they were saved by their works in the flesh, which works were taught unto them by their leaders. 36. Yea, the Jews believed that in the sacrifices and the ordinances that were administered unto them in the temples of God, by those who had been given the authority of God, were they saved. And these are the only works that they believed that they needed to do to be saved. 37. And when Jesus explained unto them that they did not need to do any of these things to be saved, but that they only needed to love their neighbor as themselves, they could not accept these things, because of their traditions and their faith and their trust in the leaders of their church. 38. And it shall come to pass in the latter days, even among those who shall belong to the church called the Church of Jesus Christ of the latter days, that they shall be like unto the Jews in every way. 39. For they shall be taught by their leaders that a person must be baptized by one who hath authority in their church and receive all the ordinances of the temple of God, or this person will not be saved in the kingdom of God. 39. And like the Jews in the time of Christ, they shall forget the simplicity of the message of Christ and do the things that are required of them by their church. But they shall be angry one with another, and they shall put themselves above their neighbor, even that they shall command their daughters that they shall not marry any man that is not a member of their church because of their pride. 40. And they shall command their children that they shall not play with those who are not of their faith. And they shall not allow in their churches and their temples those who do not abide by the commandments of the church according to the words of its leaders, even though these that they do not allow into their church might abide by all the words of Christ. 41. And they shall sue in the courts of law one another, and seek for glory and riches of the world, and set themselves up as a light unto the world, and send forth missionaries into every part of the world, that they might convert all the children of men to their religion. 42. And when they find the one that will give heed unto their words, they shall testify to him that they believe in Christ, and that they are the only true church of Christ upon the earth. Nevertheless, they shall not require that person obey the words of Christ, but the words of their church. 43. And Satan shall use this church to deceive the earth, and turn the people further from the message of Christ. And this church shall grow in strength, even by the power that Satan shall give unto it. But its numbers shall be few, and the strength that they shall receive shall be the strength that Satan shall give unto them, because of their riches and the money that they have taken from the people in their tithes and offerings. 44. And they shall be involved in many of the governments of the earth, and exercise their influence over many people because of their riches and the secret combinations that they have established to do the will of the Lord, as they suppose. Now this is the exact situation in which the church at Jerusalem found itself among the Jews at the time of Christ. 45. And this last prophet who shall be among them in the latter days, even he who shall bring forth this record unto them, shall preach repentance unto them, and attempt to give unto them the simplicity of the gospel of Christ, even in its fullness. 46. And they shall reject him as the Jews rejected Christ, he being a bearer of Christ, calling him a devil and an apostate of the truth, and filled with all manner of wickedness in that which he shall teach the people. 47. And as the Jews regarded Jesus a sinner among them, so shall this latter-day church regard this last of the two prophets of which I have spoken to you concerning this record. 48. And this prophet, who is the bearer of Christ, shall act in the calling of Elijah, and make one final attempt to turn the hearts of the children to their fathers, even in teaching them the words of the Father, that they should love one another, and do unto others what they would want others to do unto them. 49. But because he shall usurp the authority of this church of the latter days, they shall reject him, and make an attempt to turn the people against him. 50. But this record shall go forth before him, and shall testify of him, and it shall also testify of Christ, and give unto the world the gospel of Christ, and explain in simplicity and plainness all of the works of Christ, which are the works of the Father. 51. But behold, the people of the church of Jesus Christ of the latter days, as well as all the earth, shall have an opportunity to humble themselves, and repent of their iniquities and their sins, and open up their eyes that they might see, and their hearts that they might understand. 52. And because the Lord shall no longer command this final prophet to speak to the people in parables, he shall give unto the people all things in plainness, that they cannot err in their understanding. 53. And if the people of the latter days begin to repent of their sins, and turn once again to the words of Christ, then the Father will send forth his Spirit unto them, and heal them, and gather them up against the wicked, which shall be many upon the earth. 54. Then shall the words of the first prophet of the latter days be fulfilled, which he wrote, saying, And also the Lord shall have power over his saints, and shall reign in their midst, and shall come down in judgment upon Idumea, all the world. 55. Therefore, the Lord hath given unto you a commandment by the voice of this prophet, that ye should search these commandments, for they are true and faithful, and the prophecies and promises that are in them shall all be fulfilled. What I, the Lord, have spoken, I have spoken, and I excuse not myself. And though the heavens and the earth pass away, my word shall not pass away, but shall all be fulfilled, whether by mine own voice or by the voice of my servants, it is the same. 56. For behold, and lo, the Lord is God, and the Spirit beareth record, and the record is true, and the truth abideth for ever and ever. 57. And now the Lord hath commanded me to explain in simplicity and plainness some of the parables that ye have received in the account that ye have before you, even that ye might better understand the things that Jesus taught unto his disciples. For unto his disciples Jesus spoke in simplicity and plainness, as it hath been explained unto you. 58. And now, everything that Jesus taught can be correlated to the commandment of the Father, that we should love each other as ourselves. 59. And for this reason the Lord condemneth the rich, and those who have more than others. And he taught his disciples of the great evils that come about because of money. And his teachings are plain and easy to understand regarding these things. But those of you in the latter days who call yourselves Christians, and who are rich, do not have eyes that see, neither do ye have ears that hear, and ye do not understand that if ye are rich, then ye are wicked. 60. For there is no man who is rich who shall see the kingdom of God in any way unless he repenteth of that which he hath done to become rich. Now it mattereth not to the Lord how much income a man might make, but it mattereth to the Lord how that income was made, and why that man useth that income to consume it upon the lust of his own flesh. 61. And ye of the latter days shall convince yourselves that your riches are a blessing of your industry, and that ye have received of your riches because of the sweat of your own brow. And Satan would have ye believe these things, that ye might justify that which ye have. And if ye truly understand the words of Jesus, then ye cannot be rich, for it would be impossible. 62. And for this reason there shall be many of the rich of the latter days that belong to this church that calls itself after the name of Jesus Christ. For the commandments of this church are easy for them to obey, and these commandments of men help them to justify their riches, and that which they have been deceived into believing hath been given unto them by God. 63. And they think they are righteous because they obey all the commandments of the church. And they are like unto the young man who came unto Jesus, and in his pride thought of himself as righteous, and said unto Jesus, Good Master, what good thing shall I do, that I may have eternal life? 64. And he said unto him, Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God, who is our Father. And we brothers are his sons. But if thou wilt know the Father and enter into life, then ye must keep the commandments of the Father. 65. And the young man saith unto Jesus, Which commandments of the Father shall I keep? And Jesus perceived his thoughts and knew of the commandments that the young man had kept according to the law of Moses. 66. And Jesus said, Thou shalt do no murder, thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness, honor thy father and thy mother, for all these are the law that hath been given unto you by the scribes and Pharisees. 67. But the commandment of the Father hath fulfilled all these things, and is encompassed into a commandment that thou keepest not, but which thou must keep in order to inherit the kingdom of the Father. Even that thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. 68. And the young man saith unto him, All these things have I kept from my youth up. What lack I yet to show unto the Father that I love my neighbor as myself? 69. And Jesus said unto him, If thou wilt be perfect, even as our Father which is in heaven is perfect, then go and sell all that thou hast, and give to the poor, and come and follow me. And thou shalt have treasure in heaven. But when the young man heard that saying, he went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions. 70. Then said Jesus unto his disciples, Verily I say unto you, that a rich man shall hardly enter into the kingdom of heaven, because of his riches which he imparteth not unto those who are in need. 71. And again I say unto you, It is easier for a camel to enter into the city through the gate, which is the eye of the needle, than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. For in order for a camel to enter into the city through the eye of the needle, it must first be relieved of that which burdeneth it, so that it can get on its knees and pass through the gate into the city. 72. Likewise, if a man is rich, he must relieve himself of his abundance, and humble himself before God, before he can enter into the kingdom of God. 73. And when his disciples heard it, they were exceedingly amazed, saying, Who then can be saved? But Jesus perceived their thoughts, and said unto them, With men this is impossible, but if they will forsake all things for my sake, with God whatsoever I speak is possible. 74. Then answered Peter and said unto him, Behold, we have forsaken all, and followed thee. What shall we have therefore in the kingdom of God? 75. And Jesus said unto them, Verily I say unto you, that ye who have followed me, and believed in me, and have obeyed the commandments of the Father in all things, in the resurrection when the Son of Man shall sit in judgment of those who have rejected these things before the throne of the glory of the Father, then ye also shall sit in judgment, judging the 12 tribes of Israel, because unto them shall I send you to preach unto them these things. 76. And because we have preached these things unto them, our testimony shall be given before the Father, that they might be judged according to those things which we preached unto them. And our testimonies against them shall stand before the Father, even that they were given the chance to obey his commandments. 77. And our testimonies and our words shall judge them before the Father, because they did not believe in that which we were sent to teach unto them. 78. And every one of you that hath forsaken houses, or brethren, or sisters, or father, or mother, or wife, or children, or lands, for the sake of my name, shall receive 100-fold of the happiness that these things would have brought unto you in the flesh, and these shall inherit everlasting life. 79. But many unto whom we preach these things, which are first, shall be last in the resurrection, because they refuse the commandments of the Father as we have given them. 80. And many of them that shall receive this gospel, after it hath been rejected by the Jews, yea, even the Gentiles, which are the last, shall be first to be resurrected unto everlasting life, because they rejoiced in the Father, and kept his commandments. 81. But in the end, all those who are first shall be last, and those that are last shall be first. For the Father shall save all of his children as soon as they are willing to keep his commandments, which he hath commanded me to give unto them. 82. And all shall be equally blessed of the Father, whether they were resurrected first or last, all shall be heirs of his kingdom, and given that which the Father promised them in the beginning. 83. For the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man that is an householder, which went out early in the morning to hire laborers into his vineyard. And when he had agreed with the laborers for a penny a day, he sent them into his vineyard. 84. And he went out about the third hour, and saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and said unto them, Go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right I will give you. And they went their way. 85. Again he went out about the sixth and ninth hour, and did likewise. 86. And about the 11th hour he went out, and found others standing idle, and saith unto them, Why stand ye here all the day idle? They say unto him, Because no man hath hired us. He saith unto them, Go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right, that shall ye receive. 87. So when even was come, the Lord of the vineyard saith unto his steward, Call the laborers, and give them their hire, beginning from the last unto the first. 88. And when they came that were hired about the 11th hour, they received every man a penny. But when the first came, they supposed that they should have received more, and they likewise received every man a penny. 89. And when they had received it, they murmured against the good man of the house, saying, These last have wrought but 1 hour, and thou hast made them equal unto us, which have borne the burden and heat of the day. 90. But he answered one of them and said, Friend, I do thee no wrong. Didst not thou agree with me for a penny? Take that thine is, and go thy way, for I will give unto this last, even as unto thee. 91. Is it not lawful for me to do what I will with mine own? Is thine eye evil, because I am good? 92. And thus spoke Jesus in parable, that his disciples might understand that the last shall be first, and the first shall be last in the kingdom of the Father. For many are called, but few chosen, and they that are not chosen, because they complain against the Father, who rendereth equally in all things which pertain unto his children. End of chapter 48.